Hey guys, my name is Kuyanche and welcome to episode 18 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So as you recall, last episode we talked about how you're able to connect multiple Logistics Pipes networks remotely together. In this episode we'll start talking about auto-crafting using forestry thermionic fabricators. So let's get started. Even though this is not the most difficult tutorial that I have made, because some of you guys requested it, I decided to make a video of it nonetheless, because if you guys have questions, I am more than welcome to actually answer it. So of course, I got myself a cool tutorial world for you guys set up, with of course the basic power, the creative energy cell to actually supply it, the basic pipe on here, the chest that is used for storage, and a request pipe to actually request things. But of course, you are here for the thermionic fabricator part. Surprisingly, logistics pipes and thermionic fabricators on its own work pretty smart already. Pretty much meaning that if you were to set up a thermionic fabricator, what you do is you set up a recipe, for example this one, which is for the golden electron tubes, which requires 5 gold and 2 redstone dust. And you will need some sort of molten liquid in the top left, being sandstone, regular sand or glass. Sander glass gives 1000 millibuckets of molten, well, glass, but the difference in the smelting temperature will pretty much determine the power usage. So what I did is I got myself 3 thermionic fabricators, one set up for the golden electron tubes, one for the copper ones, and one for the tin ones. Sadly, this is the only way I could figure out to actually set up the recipe. You cannot use one thermionic fabricator for multiple recipes as, if you want to autocraft it, you need to have it configured. So the good thing about the crafting logistics pipes is that if you set up a recipe like follows, what I had to do is make the recipe double, because each of these electron tubes, or at least this recipe that I got set up, will give you 4 electron tubes, but will only use up 500 millibuckets of molten liquid resources, as this tooltip will pretty much say. Though the thing is that, like I mentioned, sand and glass will give you 1000 millibuckets or a full bucket's worth. So to use it completely up, I had to use double the recipe, so that will mean 4 redstone, 10 gold ingots, and 1 piece of sand will give you 8 golden electron tubes. Luckily, this thing is smart enough to automatically put the sand or glass in its appropriate location, so that is pretty cool. And then of course you will have to supply it with some power. Of course you can either do it with some redstone energy flux ducts, or of course the logistics pipes method, which I already showcased a few times before. If you missed it, click the link right here to actually learn how to transmit power through logistics pipes. So yes, that is pretty much all it is actually to it to autocraft using thermionic fabricators. Of course, let's quickly demonstrate this to you guys. Using the request logistics pipe. As you can see, I got myself a bunch of resources in this chest right here. Pretty cool. If I were to want to request, let's say, 8 copper, the items are sent into the appropriate location. The sand is being put in here. Because this machine is getting a steady supply of power, it will automatically melt it to liquid glass. Do keep that in mind, as these machines also require power when it has a recipe set up, even when it's not actually crafting. So keep that in mind, pretty important. And then that's pretty much all you need to it. Of course, you can add more recipes that require these electron tubes using the logistics crafting table or whatever method you prefer of any other auto-crafting. But yeah, it works surprisingly cool and yeah, pretty straightforward too. And with that guys, I think it would be a good wrapping up point. Like I said, it is not the most difficult solution, but I definitely hope you guys learned something from it and will be able to adapt it into your own Minecraft world. So like always, if you have any more questions or suggestions, feedback, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. Be sure to like, comment and subscribe, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care folks.